Can a budget AI kit really deliver big results? Join me as I set up the Jetson Orin Nano developer kit, overcome some pitfalls, and see what this little guy can do. The Jetson Orin Nano Super Developer Kit is NVIDIA's least expensive option in their robotics and edge AI category of devices. It's only $249, but it comes packed with a 6-core ARM CPU, a GPU with 1,024 CUDA cores and 32 Tensor cores, plus 8 gigabytes of memory. That's really impressive for the price, and we should be able to do a lot of cool things with this hardware. Though we are somewhat limited by having just 8 gigabytes of RAM, and it's not upgradable. I won't be using my Jetson for robotics or vision stuff with cameras, so I won't cover that today. Though NVIDIA has a whole slew of example projects with step-by-step instructions, including plenty for robotics and vision. For my Jetson, I'll cover adding an SSD, installing the Jetson software onto a microSD card, and then moving the OS to the SSD. From there, I can begin installing the tools we'll use, such as Docker, and then start running AI apps, in fewer steps than you might expect. Plus, stick around till the end when I'll show you a super handy tool for interacting with remote devices like the Nano. Wait, it's the NVIDIA Jetson Orin Nano Super Development Kit? Sounds like somebody was getting paid by the word. So first let's take a look at the Jetson Orin Nano and what I bought to go with it. Along with the dev kit, I picked up a 128GB microSD card, a 1TB SSD drive, plus an inexpensive case. I'll put the links in the description. The Jetson comes with a reference card, a power brick, and 2 different power cords. The Nano has a decent selection of ports on the back, including gigabit Ethernet and a display port, along with a handful of USB ports. From the top, we can see the 2 camera connectors, along with the main compute module. And on the underside, we have a Wi-Fi card and 2 NVMe slots, one for the smaller 2230 size, and the other for the larger and more common 2280 size, which is what I'll be installing. To install the NVMe SSD, we just remove a single screw, then gently slide the drive into the slot at an angle, and secure it in place with the screw.
I think this might be a bomb disposal robot, Roy.
I'm just having a couple of problems with it.
What kind of operating system does it use?
It's Vista!
We're going to die!
So we're almost ready to fire this baby up. However, first we need to flash that SD card with the Jetson operating system, called Jetpack, which we can download from the NVIDIA website. I'll use a free app called Bolina Etcher to write the Jetpack software to the SD card, though you can also use another free app called Rufus if you prefer. Inserting the SD card into the Nano can be tricky, as the slot is in a tough-to-reach spot on the underside of the compute module. We connect the power brick along with a keyboard and mouse. And for the display, I'm using a video capture device to show the screen on a laptop. When we boot for the first time, it boots from the SD card and launches into a standard Ubuntu setup wizard, where we select our region and language, connect to a Wi-Fi network, create our login account, and wait for it to install. By the way, the first time I installed Linux was back in the late 90s, and I don't recall which distro I used, but I distinctly remember that I had to download the source code and compile my network card drivers myself. Not exactly a beginner-friendly experience.
Now, to take the ferry cost a nickel, and in those days, nickels had pictures of bumblebees on them. Give me 5 bees for a quarter, you'd say. Now, where were we? Oh, yeah.
The next step is to move the Jetpack OS from the SD card to the SSD because it's much faster, more reliable, and has plenty of room to install apps and store large AI model files. Fortunately, there's a great YouTube channel called Jetson Hacks that's done the hard work for us and has published their migration scripts to GitHub for us to use. They've got an entire video detailing that process, and I'll include a link in the description. To obtain the scripts, we just need to clone the Migrate Jetson to SSD repo from the Jetson Hacks page on GitHub. We do this with a git clone command, along with the repo's URL that we copy from GitHub. The instructions were very easy to follow, with three separate scripts to run. The first script, called make partitions, creates the new empty partitions on the solid-state drive. And then the copy partitions script copies everything from the SD card to the SSD, including the Jetpack OS. This can take a few minutes. Once everything is copied, we run the configure SSD boot script, which reconfigures the Nano to boot to the SSD instead of the SD card. And the last thing we need to do for the SSD is to expand the main partition to take up the rest of our 1 TB capacity. To do this, we'll install a free partition manager app called gparted, which allows us to easily expand our partitions. Hey, real quick, if you're getting something out of this video today, please give us a like and consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for your support, it really helps. At this point, we should be done with the SD card, so I removed the card and installed the Jetson Orin Nano into its case, which leaves the SD card slot inaccessible. The case I bought was only around $22, but it did not come with any written instructions. However, it was easy enough to find their video instructions here on YouTube, and I'll link to that video as well in the description. Oh, and I had these lying around, so I decided to give it a little personality. I've never named a computer before because I think it's kind of weird, but if you have any suggestions for a great name for this fella, leave them in the comments.
Easy.
Now that the Jetpack OS is installed and running on our SSD, we can start installing AI apps. And NVIDIA has an entire website dedicated to the Jetson series, with lots of helpful information, documentation, and a long list of tutorials covering AI projects in text, vision, and robotics. Keep in mind, though, that not all of these projects will run on the Nano. Some require one of the more powerful models, but each tutorial has a What You Need section that shows which Jetson models are supported. While we do have the option of installing these apps directly onto our Nano, a much easier approach is to use Docker to run the apps inside of containers instead. On the Jetson, there's a special implementation of Docker called Jetson Containers that's pre-configured to work properly with Jetson devices like ours. And by the way, from here on out, I'll mostly perform tasks on the Jetson through an SSH terminal on another PC or Mac. To install Jetson containers, we just need to clone the GitHub repo, similar to what we did before, and then run a build command. As soon as that build completes, we can immediately begin running AI apps in containers. And we'll start with Ollama, which is a great free tool that allows you to run large language models on your own hardware. We just copy the Jetson containers command from the Ollama tutorial page and paste it into the terminal. Once the Ollama image is downloaded, it launches the container and drops us into it, so we can launch the Ollama client and tell it to use a particular model. If we don't already have that model, it will go and download it from the web. When the download finishes, we can begin chatting with the model directly in the terminal. Now, as great as that is, it would be even better if we had some kind of web client like we're used to using with ChatGPT and the other guys. That's where OpenWebUI comes in. It acts as the front-end web client for Ollama, and we can run OpenWebUI in a container too. This one was a little bit trickier to set up because the two containers need to talk to each other. But once I found the correct Docker command for OpenWebUI, it worked right away. OpenWebUI provides a familiar and easy-to-use interface for Ollama and other AI engines and services, like LM Studio or any other OpenAI-compatible service.
Sir, it's quite possible that this Jetson software is not entirely stable.
Not entirely stable? Well, I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Things were working great, and I was already starting to think about maybe putting more stuff on the Nano. Maybe run Pi-hole. Maybe a media server. That is, until I was rudely reminded that this is a developer kit. Somewhere along the way, the Jetpack OS was updated to the latest firmware in OS. And that's when things started to go south. First, I noticed that web browsers on the Nano had stopped working, and after a little digging, I found that others were having the same issue. Once again, though, Jetson Hacks saves the day, this time with an article and video describing the problem, the exact reason for it, and a pretty easy workaround of installing the browsers via Flatpak instead of Snap. I'll link to the Jetson Hacks video if you'd like more details on that. Then after another OS update, users started experiencing camera issues and memory errors while using AI apps like Ollama. And unfortunately, I ran into this problem too. Until NVIDIA releases a fix, I can try reverting to the previous version of the OS. So I reflash my SD card with Jetpack 6.2.1 and begin the setup process over again. I go through the Ubuntu setup on the SD card, then move the OS onto the SSD, and expand the partition. This time though, I configure the system not to update the kernel or firmware until further notice. Just like before, I install Jetson containers, run an Ollama Docker image, download a model, and cross my fingers. I breathe a sigh of relief when I see that Ollama seems to be responding totally normal now. I can load a typical model file and see in JTOP that it does seem to be getting all the GPU and memory it needs. I'm getting a pretty slow 8 tokens per second with a 7 billion parameter DeepSeek model, but if I load a smaller 1.5 billion parameter version, I get a more respectable 27 tokens per second. Hey, remember earlier I mentioned that I had a great tool to share with you for connecting to and managing remote systems like the Nano. And it's a tool you might already have installed. It's Visual Studio Code, which is free from Microsoft and it's cross-platform. There's even a Linux version. VS Code has a built-in SSH client, so you can use it to connect to your Nano and browse through the file system. You can drag and drop to upload files and download with a simple right click. Plus, you can use the excellent editor in VS Code as your text editor instead of using the native Linux editors like Vi or Nano. There's even plugins to help manage your Docker containers. So VS Code is a wonderful tool to make life just a little bit easier when working with your Jetson Orin Nano. All right, so after quite an adventure with software updates, we finally got our Jetson mostly working. And it'll be great for experimenting with some really cool AI stuff. I think my biggest takeaway is a reminder to treat this device like the developer kit that it is. Things are going to break, and you need to be ready to do some troubleshooting. Please hit that like button and consider subscribing to the channel for more tech videos like this. Thanks for watching.